When you take steps of faith, some people won't understand. They may find fault, try to talk you out of it. I don't think that's right. But God didn't put the thirst in them. Don't let that keep you from pursuing what God put in your heart. When you're thirsty, it may ruffle some feathers. When you're thirsty, doors may close before they open. When you're thirsty, you may have to dig ditches when there's no water, do things that don't make sense. But when you're thirsty, you'll see God show out in your life. He'll bring water without rain. He'll open doors you never dreamed would open. He'll take you further than you've imagined. Are you thirsty, or have you gotten complacent, put dreams on hold, living passive? Maybe one day you'll get your fire back. The problem is you're dehydrated, not physically, but spiritually. Your thirst has been numbed. When you push those dreams down so long, you lose your natural inclination to drink. I believe today thirst is coming back. Dreams are waking up. What God promised you is still alive on the inside. Now do your part. Start believing again. Get your fire back. Get your passion back. If you'll stay thirsty, God will satisfy you with good things. Even dreams you've let go of. You think it's too late, God can still bring them to pass. I met a 106-year-old man after the service a while back. He was so likable. He looked like he was 70 years old. He didn't have one wrinkle on his face. I commented on how good he looked. He's African American. He touched his face and said, "Joel, black don't crack." He was so funny and so good-natured. And I asked him how long he was planning on living. I'll never forget what he told me. He said, "I have 7 children. One of my sons is not serving God. He's off track, not making good decisions. God promised that as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I'm not going to die until I see him back on course." 106 years old, and he's still thirsty. He's still expecting God to bring promises to pass. He could have thought, "Oh man, 6 out of 7 children, doing good, that's not bad. I've lived a long, healthy life, that's good enough." No, don't water down what God promised you. Stay passionate. Keep believing for the fullness of your destiny. This is what Caleb did in the scripture. He was 40 years old when he and Joshua spied out the promised land. They were the only 2 out of 12 spies that had a positive report. They said, "We can take the land, let us go in at once." The other spies told Moses, "The people are too big. There are giants in the land." That word spread throughout the camp. Before long, all 2 million of the Israelites were discouraged. They never did make it into the promised land. Caleb could have lived bitter. It wasn't his fault. He had faith. Other people kept him from going in. But 45 years later, Caleb was 85 years old. The children of the Israelites were about to go into the promised land. You would think Caleb would be retired, old and frail. But Caleb said, "Joshua, I'm still as strong today as the day Moses sent me out 45 years ago." He looked at the mountain, the same place they had spied out with the giants in the land. He said, "I want that mountain." Joshua could have said, "Caleb, there are still giants on that land. You're too old. Let me give you this other place." Caleb said, "No, Joshua, I'm still thirsty. I'm still believing for what God promised me that it will come to pass." Yes, he had had delays, bad breaks, people that didn't believe, but that didn't stop him from becoming all he was created to be.
I hope you enjoyed watching this clip. You can watch the full message here on our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear your prayer request and how the ministry has impacted your life. You can leave a comment below. Make sure to subscribe to our channel to stay inspired all throughout the week. We'll see you next time.